Hey there, YouTubers. It's Don from Sure Cable coming back at you again with Dave Harris from Sure Cable as well. And we're going to be talking about single mode versus multi-mode and the differences between the two, where you commonly see one being used over another, or, you know, where one might be taking over from another. And today we thought we would be a little bit fun and actually dress up as the cables that we're going to be. So I'm multi-mode. And Dave is going to be single mode, and we're going to talk about our relative merits and some of the key differentiators in speed, distance, and some of the other physical construction differences between the two types of fiber optical cable. So stick around. We'll be right back. All right. Well, thank you very much for sticking around and joining us for this little talk about the differences between single and multi-mode fiber optical cable. I am multi-mode, and I'm Don, but we're going to call me multi-mode for the purposes of this video. Anyway, you notice that we're in different shirt colors. Well, that's because fiber optic communications cable typically has a pretty strict color code associated with it. Now, copper twisted pair Ethernet, there is a standard that's defined, but it's loosely followed. With fiber, it's much more strictly followed. So when it comes to fiber optical cable, typically the only time you see yellow is when it's associated with OS2 single mode fiber optic cable. When it comes to multi-mode cable, well, we're going to go a little further back on that. It is multiple colors involved because all of the multi-mode fiber is better off for a while. And a different core diameters. So it started off way back when, a long time ago, with OM1. And that was typically seen in orange, along with OM2 and OM3, more typically orange. Sometimes you saw OM3 in aqua. And the way that worked was it had a 62.5 micron core diameter, and then had some cladding on top of it, and then it was used to transmit light pulses. Then we got into OM4, which could either be aqua or it could be Erica Violet, which is the color I have on. And then, of course, single mode came about, and that's where you get the yellow. Now, what are the main differences? Okay, so it's going to have to do with core diameter. So the OM1 was 62.5 micron core diameter. The cladding diameter was typically 125 micron, so not much change. So when you started getting OM2, OM3, OM4, OM5, the main two differences there are that the core diameter was reduced down to 50 and then 125 total for the cladding. And then you started seeing laser optimization introduced with OM4. So the ability of the quality of the fiber essentially improved, allowing it to carry more data over longer distances. So multi-mode fiber is mostly used for shorter haul fiber runs. For example, you can get away with 1 gigabit data networking with multi-mode fiber up to about 3,200 feet. When you're talking about 10 gigabit and higher, now you are 1,300 feet and less. Sometimes you see 1,800 feet. It has to do with the difference in the application. If you're talking about 40 gigabit speeds over multi-mode, now you're at about 500 feet. So it's good for short haul, and it's relatively low cost. The transceivers that are used with it are low cost. They're called vertical cavity surface emitting lasers. They used to be lead transmitters because multimode operates at 850 nanometer wavelength, which is infrared. And so the low cost vertical cavity or VCSEL laser, surface emitting laser, is a relatively inexpensive mass produced laser. And it can be used up to pretty good distances before, you know, it starts losing its ability to transmit. It might sound like multi-mode is an advantage over single mode. So you might think multi is somehow better than single because he's only single, right? Well, in reality, multi-mode is multi in not a good way because of the core diameter of the 50 microns. It allows the light to scatter and it becomes multi-mode unintentionally through the core and the cladding. And what that does is it causes modal dispersion, which limits its ability to transmit data and or at a certain speed or a certain speed over a certain distance. So when you're talking about multimode fiber, 1 gigabit at 3,200 feet or so, oftentimes you're 1,300 feet or less with it if you're looking to push 10 gigabit. So that's really the application for multimode. You can connectorize it pretty much any way you wish, just like you can with single mode. So multimode is typically associated with the LC connector, the Lucent style connector, which you're probably familiar with, MPO-NPT high density connectors with 12 or 24 strands. Then you have SC connectors, which have been around for a long time, and the ST connector as well, but that's a very old connector. It's the twist-on style. You don't usually see that much anymore. So multimode has been seen with lots of different kinds of connectors over time. But the most common ones nowadays are the high-density MPO-NPT and LC, occasionally SC. So that's pretty much it about multimode. So when you look at a fiber cable and you're seeing Erica Violet or Aqua or Orange, you're dealing with multimode fiber. So, single.
Hi. Before you say that multimode is not the greatest, I just need to remind people that there are some specialty applications that need to operate over more than one or two wavelengths. And for that, multimode is preferred. But that's not normally what's going on in Ethernet transmission. And why is single mode better or faster or longer? Well, let's start with the core. The core is really small, 9 microns, 9/1000ths of a millimeter. That's tiny. There are very few wavelengths that are capable of transmitting. So, in fact, those wavelengths are 1310 nanometers. And 1550 nanometers. Those are the wavelengths that single mode fiber can operate over. Since single mode fiber can operate at two distinct wavelengths, it lends itself to operation at full duplex, in full duplex mode, over a single fiber, because it can operate in one direction at 1550 and the other direction at 1310.
Bidirectional.
Thanks, Tom. Bidirectional, right. And that it doubles the speed, or, well, not exactly doubles, but it increases the speed a lot. Although the same protocols operate over multimode as single mode, single mode is able to transmit over a much farther distance because of the lack of dispersion.
Yeah, I'm scatterbrained. As multimode, I am scatterbrained because my modes are always bouncing around and scattering and getting all messed up. You know, by the time you get out to a certain distance, it's like, you know, I'm sure I'm even multi-mode anymore. I'm not sure where I am. But single mode, man, it's like, wow. Yeah, I mean, he's got powerful lasers. I've only got to go to the cheap lasers.
Single mode fiber makes use of powerful lasers. One of the ones I know is called an FP laser. And with the use of that laser at 1 gigabit per second, I can go 60 miles. 10 gigabits per second, I can go 25 miles. And I'm not just a distance runner, I'm a distance sprinter. So even though my lasers are more expensive, it's worth it.
And dangerous. I mean, okay, so, you know, being multimode, my vertical cavity surface emitting lasers, they are, well, they're potentially, if you go looking dead on into the end of a fiber that's using a VCSEL laser, you could damage your cornea, more than likely temporary blindness. But his lasers, the ones that he uses for his type of data transmission, what will they do to you if you look dead on at one?
It'll hurt. Yeah. You'll burn your retina, but it'll also be pink. And you won't see it because fiber optics operates over invisible wavelengths. So,
and his lasers cost a lot more, too, because they're real powerful lasers.
But they're worth it.
Yeah, they're worth it.
Yeah. Single mode fiber uses the same connectors as multimode up to a point. Multimode has been around longer, and so there are some old connectors that you probably won't find on single mode. But you definitely will find the LC type of connector, which is very up to date. You'll find MTP and MPO connectors for multi fibers. just like it, multimode. And you'll also find SC connectors, just like on multimode for, usually for, you'll find those in fiber to the home applications and in data centers.
So that pretty much sums up the similarities and differences between multimode and single mode. And if you've got any additional questions, we've written quite a few blogs, and we have other videos about the subject, not just about the fibers, but about the connectorization, because one of the confusing things about fiber optic is not so much that the modes, that can be confusing, but it's the different types of connectors you find. And here's a bit of a spoiler alert for you. The connector that's on the end of the cable is totally dependent upon the equipment you're plugging it into. So, and the transceiver, which is the equipment. So, but refer back to our Cable Academy, where we have plenty of blogs regarding fiber and connectorization and how that all works and where you see different connectors being used on what. And with that, I'm going to say you have a great day and happy networking.
Looking for your next Sure Cable adventure? We've got some awesome content in our Cable Academy down below. And if you're looking for some fun videos, check them out over here. All right, go for another adventure.